Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we'll take a look at strong bases. You can find this entire video series along with a practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, leiaforsci.com/MCAT acid base. Just like a strong acid, a strong base is one that will dissociate or react 100% when dissolved in solution. If we place a strong base like NaOH in water, it'll dissociate 100% to give me Na+ and OH-. We have a one-way arrow to show that this is a reaction that goes to completion, and this is a strong base. NaOH qualifies as an Arrhenius base because we get the OH- in solution if the solution is water. But a strong base doesn't just have to have an OH in it. It can also react with water or another solution to give you that OH-. For example, the methide ion, CH3-, when dissolved in water will react with water to give you methane, which is CH4, but now that fourth hydrogen comes from H2O, and what you're left with in solution is OH-, once again an Arrhenius base. But this can also happen in a non-water solution. That means it falls under the Bronsted-Lowry category. For example, if I take the same CH3-, but this time I dissolve it in solution of ammonia, NH3, it'll still react to give me CH4, but this time the base that forms is the amide, NH2- instead of OH-. A weak base, on the other hand, is one that does not go to completion. For example, if I dissolve NH3, ammonia, in water, it'll react with water very similarly to the CH3-. We'll show equilibrium arrows, and then our product of NH4+ and OH-. Because ammonia is a weak base, we have to show the equilibrium arrows because the reaction doesn't go to completion. When ammonia is dissolved in water, you'll have some ammonia and then some ammonium, but they'll keep going back and forth in equilibrium so that we have some ratio of ammonia to ammonium. The strong bases that you want to memorize for your MCAT are the hydroxides that are paired with alkali metals, group 1 on the periodic table, and alkali earth metals, group 2 on the periodic table. Here's a list of some of the strong bases you want to memorize for your MCAT. Are hydroxides that are paired with your alkali metals, which are group 1 on the periodic table, and the alkaline earth metals, which are group 2 on the periodic table. But the alkaline earth have 2 hydroxides, so don't forget to account for them in your calculations. Also recognize that some of the heavier alkaline earth metal bases will be more soluble in an acidic solution and less soluble in a basic solution due to the common ion effect. When it comes to determining the strength of a base, you can measure it in pH or pOH. Remember that if P of anything is equal to negative log of that thing, then pH is equal to negative log of the H+ concentration, something we looked at in the acid video, and pOH is equal to the negative log of the OH- concentration. However, on the MCAT, you can expect to have to measure bases in both pH and pOH, more so than acids will be measured in pOH. That means you have to be comfortable going between them. The two important equations to remember are that Kw is equal to the H+ concentration times the OH- concentration, which is equal to 1 × 10⁻¹⁴ at 25 degrees Celsius. Taking the P of this entire equation, we get that pKw is equal to pH, multiplication becomes plus pOH, and that is equal to just 14, again at 25 degrees Celsius. So let's try a few quick practice problems. Say you're given a 0.01 molar solution of KOH and asked to find the pH. First thing we want to recognize is that KOH is a strong base and will give us 100% dissociation. So the molarity of KOH is automatically equal to the molarity of OH- because it dissociates 100% to OH- ions. And if the concentration of OH- is equal to 0.01, we have two ways to find the pH. The first thing we can do is use the Kw is equal to H plus times OH minus. But I don't want to deal with exponents and scientific notation if I don't have to. So I prefer to go the second route. Find the pOH from the OH minus concentration, and then use the pOH to find the pH much faster and, honestly, way less stressful. The pOH is equal to negative log the OH minus concentration of 0.01, which will first turn into scientific notation of 1 times 10 to the minus 1, 2. 1 times 10 to the minus 2, which means our pOH is equal to 2. If you're not familiar with this trick, go back to my MCAT Math video series, which you can find on my website, layerforsci.com/MCATMath. If pKw of 14 is equal to pH plus pOH, to find the pH, we simply do 14 minus 2, which is equal to 12, and that's our pH. Let's do another example, where this time you're given 0.05 moles of calcium hydroxide dissolved in 500 milliliters of water, and you're asked to find the pH. First thing we want to do is figure out our path. If we're going from a base to pH, I prefer to find from base to pOH to pH, and in order to find the pOH, I need the OH minus concentration. To find the concentration, we'll use the equation of molarity is equal to moles per liter, and in this case, we're given 0.05 moles divided by a volume of 500 milliliters, which is not liters. To go from milliliters to liters, you have to divide by 1,000 or use the simple trick of move the decimal back 3 spaces, which gives us 0.5 liters. Great setup, but there's way too much going on. Decimals and fractions at the same time, this is too much for the MCAT. So let's simplify as much as we can. If we divide the 5 out for the top and bottom, replace with a 1 since 5 divided by 5 is 1 for both top and bottom, this gives me 0.01 over 0.1, but I want to get rid of the decimal, especially in the denominator, so I'll move the decimal 1 space to the right top and bottom, which is the same thing as multiplying by 10 over 10, or 1, and that gives me 0.1 moles per liter, or 0.1 molar. But this is not my OH minus concentration. 0.1 molar is the concentration of calcium hydroxide. And you can't forget that for every one molecule of calcium hydroxide, we have two ions of OH minus. So every 1 mole of calcium hydroxide gives us 2 moles of hydroxide. You should recognize that all you have to do is multiply it by 2. But if you're not sure, here's the setup. 0.1 molar calcium hydroxide times the ratio of 1 calcium hydroxide for every 2 OH minus. This shows you that we multiply by 2. 2 times 1 is 2, with 1 decimal space gives us 0.2 molar, and that's our OH minus concentration. So the pOH is equal to negative log of 0.2, which is the same thing as saying negative log of 2 times 10 to the minus 1. 2 times 10 to the minus 1 is very close to 1 times 10 to the minus 1. So in this case, if you forgot to double it, your answer would still be close enough. We'll round it down to 1 because on the MCAT, close enough is good enough and get a pOH of 1. If pOH is around 1, then pH is around 13. Now, say you have two choices on the MCAT where 1 is slightly greater than 13 and 1 is less than 13. How do you know which one to choose? When we rounded towards fewer hydroxide ions. That means we made it more acidic than it should be, when in reality we have more hydroxide, so it's more basic. So the pOH should really be something less than 1 because it's much stronger, and therefore the pH should be something greater than 13. So all you have to look for is pH slightly greater than 13. I punched this into the calculator just to show you how close we are, and the calculator says that the pH is equal to 0.699 or 0.7, and the pH is equal to 13.3. 13.3 is slightly greater than 13, but doing this on the MCAT without a calculator would have taken you so much more time. Now there's one more thing I want to talk about when it comes to strong bases, and that's the leveling effect. Just like with acids, if you take a very strong base and dissolve it in water, the absolute strongest base that exists in water will be OH-. So how is that possible? If you started with a stronger base, shouldn't you have a stronger base in solution? We'll use the example of the methide CH3- ion, knowing that it is a much stronger base than water. If we place this into water, the strong basic electrons on the carbon will reach out and grab one of the hydrogens and pluck it right off of the water molecule to give you a CH4 gas which bubbles out of solution plus an OH- ion. The moment the methide touches water, suddenly your strongest base is only hydroxide. The idea of the leveling effect is that any really, really strong base that enters water levels off so it's only as strong as the hydroxide in water. Be sure to join me in upcoming videos where we look at calculations for weak acids and weak bases and specifically focus on MCAT appropriate shortcuts. You can find this entire series along with my practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website layerforsci.com/MCAT acid base. Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website layerforsci.com/MCAT tutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.